Right. Better go and make myself known. Behave yourselves.
Right.
See you, lads.
See you.
All right, gentlemen, gather around, please.
Well, I might as well tell you now. You lot may all be internationals and have won all the domestic honours there are to win under Don Revy. But as far as I'm concerned, the first thing you can do for me is to chuck all your medals and all your caps and all your pots and all your pans into the biggest fucking dustbin you can find, because you've never won any of them fairly. You've done it all by bloody cheating. Mr. William Bremner, you're the captain, and a good one. But you're no good to the team and you're no good to me if you're suspended. I want you fit for every game, and I want good, clean, attractive football from my captain, starting next week at the Charity Shield. And you, Irishman, God gave you skill, intelligence, and the best passing ability in the game. What God did not give you was six studs to wrap around another player's knee. Now, things are going to be a little different around here without Don. Might feel a little strange at first, might pinch a little like a new pair of shoes. But if you want your grandchildren to remember you as being something other than the dirty buggers you once were, if you want to be loved as real champions, worthy champions, you're going to have to work and improve and change. Now, let's start off by playing some seven-a-sides.
Mr. Revy never made us do that.
Well, I'm not Mr. Revy. From now on, I don't want to hear that name again, ever. Next player who mentions it, or what he did or didn't bloody do in the good old days, will spend a week cleaning my boots. Seven-a-sides. Keep it nice and clean. Hey, and sensible, no 50-50s. Right, I'll play myself. You might learn something, Irishman. 251 goals in 274 starts. Like to see Dom fucking Revy do that, eh?
First seven over here, come on.
There you go.
Come on, pal.
That's right. Yes, Irishman, I'll have it here,
Yep.
Nothing on. Back to you, back to you.
Right.
Good lad, come on.
What's the matter with you? You said no 50-50s.
What are you going to do about it? Right, book me.
Yeah. Bunch of fucking bullies.
It's a fair challenge, Norman. Fair play to you.
Come on, 1-2, pass him.
Okay.
There.
I should have stayed with Peter Taylor. I bet he's the one with all the talent anyway.
But I'll tell you,
he's no Don Revy.
Best team in the country, Leeds. Best players, best stadium, best backroom staff. That's everything, really.
Right. Last time, there was a whole division between you and Leeds. Not now. Not today. Today, we're here as second division champions and equals with Leeds. John McGovern and Billy Bremner, equals. Kevin Hector and Johnny Giles.
Equals.
Good lad, equals. Alan Hinton and Peter Lorimer.
Equals.
Equals. John O'Hare and Paul Maidley.
Equals!
Now, come on, chins up, chests out. We can take this lot. Come on!
obviously it's a terrific achievement for Derby, being promoted to the First Division. But the truth is, Leeds United have the unfortunate habit of reminding them just how far they still have to go.
They made us look like fools today.
I mean, our boys
are... What was O'Hare doing? Then Madeley bully him like that, pushing him around.
I worry about that.
Madeley's half his bloody size. O'Hare needs to toughen up. He's from the Scottish Dockyards, isn't he? What about McGovern? He was useless in the middle. Whose idea was that?
Yours.
Good lad. He was all over the place. Like the wandering Jew. Give the ball to anyone but his own. We need a ball player. A natural in midfield who can hold on to it, keep possession. Giving it away too easily.
Someone like Colin Todd.
Oh, now you're talking. Lovely pair of feet.
I've heard he wants out of Sunderland too. They're all jumping ship up there.
Go on, sign him then.
What? We can't. Longton's already told us. Club's in debt.
Well, having said that, Derby had their moments. They played some football. They were brief moments, perhaps, but they did play some football at times. But when you come up...
Oh, bollocks to that! I didn't get us all the way to the First Division so we could sit there mid-table and be cannon fodder for sides like Leeds. Sign the man.
Hang on, Brian.
I'll handle bloody Longson.
Ah, you are a disgrace! For missing the target from there, you want bloody shooting! Now get in there! That's what I pay you for!
£170,000 for Colin fucking Todd.
Correction, the almighty Colin Todd, the best technical footballer in the country.
And a salary is £300 a week. You can't pay a footballer that.
That's the way things are going, Uncle Sam. Football's all about money now.
I told you, never to go over my head again.
I've no choice. Windows opened up. You were in the bloody West Indies.
Windows? You mean there are others?
Messrs Gemmell and Hennessy.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Let me ask you a question, Uncle Sam. What did you come into football for?
Support the football club of my hometown. The club I've supported all my life.
Well, I'm sure we all admire your loyalty.
What I didn't come into it for is to be lectured by some cocky little twat from the North East.
But the way I see it, there's no point being in this game unless you want to beat the best and be the best. And that's all the people at Derby want. And if you really have their interest at heart, not just impressing your friends in the director's box, I suggest you keep your eyes on your road haulage business. Keep your opinions to yourself and start signing some fucking checks. There's a good lad. Leave the running of this football club to the professionals.
The professionals don't run the football club, Brian. The chairman does. And if it's true the football's all about money, that's the way it's going, well, that suits us chairman just fucking fine. Because we're the ones who've got it.
Come on, to feet! That's it, lad!
That's it, Albert!
So what was it last time? 5-0? 5-0?
Maybe we'll hit double figures this time, Dilly.
I'm taking the first penalty.
This should be a smashing grab, I think, yeah?
See, they've driven all the way into the car park this time.